Hello and welcome to this session on Selenium Builder. Today we are going to see how we can record a Selenium Builder test and export it as JUnit and TestNG and run it through Eclipse. So this is going to be a continuation from our last session, Selenium Builder 4, where we created a Java program inside Eclipse and we added a Selenium Builder test case and we ran it through Eclipse. We also added these jar files for Selenium. So in case you have not seen the earlier session 4, please go ahead, watch that tutorial and come back, because this is going to be a continuation from that series. So today we will do the same thing for a JUnit and a TestNG program. So let us start, and let me say step 1 will be, we have to open our Firefox and launch our Selenium Builder, and then we will record a test. So let me go to my Firefox. I'm going to Tools, Web Developer, and launch Selenium Builder, and we are going to use our same website, wordpress.com. So I'll split my window so that you can see exactly what's happening. I'll give the website name here, I'll say record, and you can see it is coming up here. I will give some dummy username, some password, click on login, and I can record a verification point now. So I want to record this account suspended message and stop recording. Okay, so now we have got this test case recorded. Now I can go to File, and here I can go to Export. In the last session we used Java, this time we are going to export as a Java JUnit. So let me use this Selenium Builder JUnit.java, and let us save it at the desktop. Okay, so let me go to my desktop and see this is getting saved here. Let us open and see what exactly we have got as a code for JUnit. And yes, we have got this entire Java JUnit code for our recording. So we can copy this and we can add it to our Eclipse project. So let us copy it from our desktop. I'm going to copy this, go to my Eclipse, and in the same project that we have created in the last session, I'm going to paste this. And now if we see this, the last session we created a simple Java program. This time it is not just a Java, it is a JUnit. So you can see these annotations. So these are JUnit annotations. It tells, add before tells that what you have to do before a test. So in before annotation, we are actually creating a Firefox driver and adding the wait timeout. So we can actually change these timeouts as well. And this is the actual test. So this is what we are doing in our actual test. And after the test, we are closing our browser. Okay. So let me also put a print statement, test completed successfully. Okay. So now I can right click here. And we can say run as, this time I will select run as JUnit test. And let us see what happens. So this is going to start a Firefox browser and run our test case. And then it will close the browser. And let us see what happened. And yes, it has verified the text and has also printed test completed successfully. And here you can see the JUnit results. So this is our JUnit test and this got passed. So this is what we can get as a report in JUnit, and this is the advantage of JUnit over a simple Java program. So we are getting results like this. Now let us again go to our Selenium builder, go to file, go to export, and this time I want to export as a testng. So I'll click here, I will say Selenium builder testng and save it. Let me go to my desktop, copy it from there and paste inside my Eclipse again. And here we can see again, this also has annotations, but now these annotations are testng annotations, and we can see this, it has already imported testng libraries. In case you do not get it already in your Eclipse, you can import the testng jar from a browser and add it like we did in our earlier session. We added Selenium jars to our project. You can add testng jars. So now again, it has before test and after method, and let me again add a print statement, test completed successfully. Now there is one more thing that we can do. We can add multiple tests here. So let me just copy this and paste it again with some other name. Okay, and let me fail this test. So I'll add something in the verification checkpoint so that it will actually fail it. And now let me run it. So I will right click here, I'll go to run as and testng test. So let us see what happens. So this is going to start the browser again and run our test case as we have recorded it. So this is the first test case that is getting executed. Now again, this is the second test case that we created. So this should fail. Okay, so let us go to our Eclipse and go to testng. And here it has actually passed both the test case, and here actually you can see what is happening is we get a summary of all the tests, we get summary of failed, and we get a summary of pass. Okay, so in our case it did not pass. So let us again go to our test case and do something else. So let me say I'm making the timeout as 10 seconds, and here I'm just making a mistake in the ID so that it will actually fail. And now I will run it again. So it will open the Firefox browser, execute the very first test case which should pass, and then the second test case. Here it should not be able to recognize the username field because we have deliberately made a mistake in the ID of the username field. So let us see what happens. So yes, it has ended. Okay, and let us go to our testng report now. And now, yes, you can see there is one pass and one failed. Okay, and when you go to click on failed, you will actually get a summary of what exactly happened. So no such element exception. So you can get exactly what happened in this user login. And then if you want to look at the failed summary, you will get the failed summary here. And again, the all the details of what exactly happened. And this is the summary of our test. So it took a total of 18.022 seconds. And these are the number of methods and number of class. So this is the advantage of using a JUnit or testng test instead of a simple Java program. And let me just quickly write the steps for you here. So step 3 will be export as JUnit and testng, step 4 will be add to Eclipse. Step 5 will be add jars if required. Step 6 will be run and validate. So this is how we can export and run as JUnit and test and gtest using Selenium Builder. Hope you like it. Thank you.